This is another Pearson Triton that's been brought to us for a major refit. We've already done the tilt-up outboard well last year. The previous owner of this boat had sailed it across the Atlantic a couple times and down to Brazil. He's already replaced the original rudder with this stainless steel straps and shaft on a new rudder. So we've got to do bottom paint, topsides paint. Original Triton rudders are wood with a bronze rudder shaft and some bolts and pins holding them together. And they're usually falling apart by this time. So fortunately, this rudder on this Triton had been replaced several years ago by a previous owner. And he built plywood and fiberglass covered rudder with a 1-inch stainless steel shaft and some heavy-duty straps. They're under this fiberglass here. 1, 2, 3, and 4. And instead of the pintles and gudgeons on the original, which were kind of flimsy and tend to wear out over time, he's got a heavy-duty, massive rudder shoe at the bottom. We've got the bottom sealed with 3 coats of 2000E barrier coat. And the rudder has been fared and primed as well. Got those fasteners sealed under some epoxy fairing compound so they can be cut into to access in the future, but it should be good for a long time, many years now. A previous owner had re-cored some deck core rot in the side decks, but there's still some ripples and waves, so I've got to fare that out. So I've already put down some 406 thickened epoxy, and after that I'm going to put some fairing compound on top and then get it all sanded fair. The paint that's on the hull topsides here was put on about 8 years ago by a previous owner, and it's a two-part perfection paint, but it has weathered and chalked up a bit. It's been in the low latitudes and tropics for most of that time. So underneath it, I found that when I was sanding that it was put on top of a single part paint. So did an acetone test here, and you do that by taping a acetone soaked rag under plastic for at least 4 hours. And if the paint softens like it is here, coming off easily with a putty knife, then that means you've probably got a single part paint, and you shouldn't put a two part over a single part, or it's not going to stick that well, or it might lift and bubble up on you. So we're going to have to sand it all down to gel coat, which is what this is right here. See, that won't scrape anymore. So that's the original gel coat there. On deck here, we've got the same issue with the old paint. There's a two-part perfection paint put on top of a single-part paint. So you can see here I did the acetone test straight in a corner where I had already sanded down to gel coat there. Here we had only sanded a little bit, part way into the coats, and this I hadn't sanded at all. So this paint is just coming right off. But over here, it's sticking well, what's left of the probably a two-part epoxy primer here. out, forward, okay. So a varnish scraping tool takes it off in one swipe. These side decks were so rough that I've had to use a longboard. This is an air sander, so that I can get it level, so it's long enough to span the low spots. Cuts pretty fast with 40 grit. For shooting the primer, I have a cheap Harbor Freight spray gun. It's a gravity feed, and it's HVLP. I put a pressure gauge on at the gun, regulator there, and then put on a dryer to get the moisture out of line. And for shooting the color coats, I've got an Anest Iwata AZ3. Bought that from a automotive paint supply shop, and it's probably about $130. At the top is the fan control, the pattern that it sprays, and then below it is the paint to air ratio, and I usually turn it out about 2.5 turns from fully closed. And this has also got another type of dryer that turns pink when it's full of moisture. And this gun, using the Alexseal paint, even though it's HVLP and you're supposed to be able to shoot with 30 pounds of pressure, I've had to turn it up to 50 pounds because the Alexseal seems to need just a lot more pressure to atomize the paint and get it to flow good. Otherwise it goes on with kind of an orange peel or a dry overspray effect. You won't be able to use these small 110 volt air compressors for spray painting a boat because even though they have high enough pressure, they don't have the volume. They won't give you the CFM you need. And also because the tank's so small, the air can heat up when it's being compressed, and you don't want to shoot paint with hot air. You need a big 220 volt compressor like this for shooting the paint. It's got a high CFM rating at a high pressure, and this is a 60 gallon tank. You'll want at least a 50 gallon tank to keep the air cool enough, and you'll have a moisture filter here and a dryer and then another filter at the gun side. This paint is highly toxic when sprayed. All two-part paints are, really. And so if you are going to be painting a lot, you'd want an air-supplied mask. But if you're only painting occasionally, you probably can get by with a 3M mask like this that has organic vapor cartridges. I sometimes use the All Grip 545 primer, otherwise I'll use this Interlux epoxy prime coat. And for spraying, you mix it 3-to-1 with the catalyst here, and then you add 25% 233N, the reducing solvent for spraying. They have a different solvent for reducing it for brushing and rolling. Goes on really rough with a roller and a brush, and that makes sanding a really big job to get it smooth. So if at all possible, it's much better to spray this on, and you'll need probably at least 3 coats. And then you have to get enough thickness on so that when you sand it smooth, you still have some primer left. The last couple of boats, including this one, I've sprayed the exterior paint using Alexseal, which is a lot like All Grip paint, very similar. For the top sides on this boat, we've used a light gray here called Pearl Gray. And up on the deck trim, the areas that are not non-skid, we sprayed with Matterhorn White, which has got just a little gray in it. And for spraying mixing, you're supposed to mix one part paint to one part converter, this one. And then they suggest you use 3/4 part reducer. And this is for moderate temperatures, a medium reducer. And on this boat, I found that there was too much orange peel in the finish using a 1:1 to 3/4 ratio. So we're using 1:1 to 1. So for example, on the top sides, we needed only 1 quart of paint and then 1 quart of the converter and then just a little couple ounces under 1 quart of the reducer. And then to that nearly 3-quart mix, I added 1 capful of the accelerator, and that will allow the paint to cure before the evening dew ruins the gloss. And you don't want to have to paint in the afternoon because you don't have enough time for the paint to cure before there's a possible evening dew. So I try not to spray after about noon. On the deck, we needed a little less than 3-quart total reduced mixed paint. And that gave us 3 coats and had a little left over. After shooting 3 coats of primer, we sanded it first with 220 grit and got it nearly smooth and then finished it up with 320 grit. And that was faster than just sanding from the start with 320. And then I shot 3 coats of Alexseal Pearl Gray. And then the same procedure on the deck using Matterhorn White.